Snowy winters bring big decisions for water releases, like when to release and how much to release. Right now, water managers at Lake Oroville are working with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers to change how some of those decisions will be made.
So let's go to meteorologist Heather Waldman right now, and she's above Lake Oroville right now in live copter 3 with a heck of a view from up there. Heather, so let's talk about the changes in the works.
Yeah, well, it may sound like an obvious idea, but scientists with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers are working on ways to implement weather forecasts when officially making those decisions for when to release and how much water to release. Historically, water managers make decisions based on how much water's on the ground and how much is stored in a snowpack. You're getting a live look at the main spillway at Lake Oroville, and making quite a bit of a release right now. Last check, just under 9,000 cubic feet per second. But of course, in a winter like what we just had, looking at what's coming a few days from now can make a huge difference in how much water needs to be released. And well, here at Lake Oroville and just up the road at New Bullards Bar, these two reservoirs are part of one of the first pilot studies in the entire country where the idea of using a weather forecast is being put to the test.
This represents a new paradigm of water management for the Corps of Engineers.
That new paradigm, using weather forecasts to make decisions on big water releases. In 2016, a major policy update allowed the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers to start incorporating weather forecasts into official flood management practices.
But the policy change just says you can do it. It doesn't say how to do that.
That's where Lake Oroville and New Bullards Bar come in. Researchers with the Corps, the Department of Water Resources, and the Yuba Water Agency have been testing the use of weather forecasts here since 2019.
This year, we've just been doing the research and the testing from a modeling perspective.
And this fall, they'll be able to run scenarios from this year's very active rain and snow season.
We'll also be looking at, okay, are there going to be certain areas that get inundated more often? And are they going to be inundated with this, higher flows than they normally see?
All of this being done virtually first to ensure safety before making any big changes to how water here is managed. The choice to add weather forecast information to official operations stems from big improvements in the weather forecast accuracy itself and need created by accelerating changes in the climate.
Being able to have more flexibility in how water management is done, I think that was part of the main motivation for that change in the water in the regulations that govern water control management in the Corps.
Talbot says that flexibility could increase water availability anywhere from 5 to 20%.
That doesn't mean that we're always going to be storing that much more water, but that we can generally make it more available based upon how, what nature gives us.
And at Lake Oroville and New Bullards Bar, forecast information like future rainfall and expected water flows isn't yet a permanent part of release decisions, but it is expected to be by the end of 2026. That's when they'll have what they call their water control manual officially updated. Those two reservoirs are being updated together because their release points combine to increase flows along the Feather River, especially near Marysville. There's still some testing and legal procedures that need to be followed first in order to make sure that these changes are made safely, but this process has already been done for Lake Mendocino. Live over Lake Oroville in Live Copter 3, meteorologist Heather Waldman, back to you.